Polkadot Stingray have a brand new song. Well, it came out a few days ago, but as I've been saying a lot of my recent reactions, I've been quite ill, so I wasn't able to catch up when I wanted to. It came out 10 days ago, and the song's called JO DEKI. I've been waiting to listen to this, but I went to listen to it along with you guys, which is quite interesting as well, because I remember back in the day when I did reactions first time round, Polkadot Stingray is one of those bands where you could never post a reaction because they'd always block it. So who knows? With a bit of luck, we might be able to listen to this together, but I've been putting off so we can. I'm intrigued as well that the first frame, she's sitting in front of washing machines. It's giving me a slight callback to previous Polkadot Stingray. Anyway, look, this is a band who, every time I hear them, I've enjoyed them. I've never really spent the time getting into their music, though. Yeah, I've never really, like, sat down and really explored their albums and stuff. So, you know, if this doesn't get blocked especially, let's go on this journey together. Tell me more Polkadot Stingray songs you want me to check out. If it does get blocked, then you're not hearing this anyway, but I'll probably go check out some music of mine. So anyway, I'm going to get a little bit of water because I've just realised I've got like a spare. When you record lots of these in a row, as I am doing now, it's just today I felt good. I'm recording lots in a row. You start to get a dry mouth. I've got the air conditioning on as well because it's boiling here in Japan. All right. Also, Caramel Candid. I think they might be Polkadot Stingray fans. I don't know. I seem to recall that somewhere. I'll check that out. Anyway, let's jump in. Check out some new Polkadot Stingray. I'm excited to see where this first frame goes, if nothing else. Oh, I love it already. It's that funkiness that they bring to a lot of their songs. It's so light and fun, but it's so full of detail. Wow, this is so joyous. Again, the nuance and the detail is what escalates it because they're so good at adding those kind of musical intricacies into their songs. I'm really charmed by this. Do you know, the smiles of the band are infectious, but the whole mood is just jumping off the screen. These 3D representations as well. This is, yeah. I I like how it's sort of gone as well. The video is sort of like deviated away towards this phone camera version. Okay. Ah, nearly got that really cool. Ooh, there's more. Wait. I want to get that really nice final frame. Oh no, I missed it again. Look, okay, so. Boing. There we go. This is a ton of fun. Now, okay, so as always, we'll be honest about this breakdown, all the honest ways, but I just wanted to jump into, first of all, well, this is what I was hoping for when I click on a new Polkadot Stingray single, as someone who, again, I've been a fairly casual listener, but I've enjoyed everything I've heard by them, and I've definitely always wanted to get more into their music. This is exactly what I really wanted to see from a return to Polkadot Stingray. Obviously, when we listen to singles, a lot of the time you do on reaction channels, you know, you're watching something with a music video, you're expecting it to be the more commercially viable side of the band. So you're not expecting it to be their most technical stuff. But with a band like Polkadot Stingray, they are always bringing a very clear level of nuance to their songs. None of their songs ever just feel like sort of dull strumming. It always feels like everything's very layered and creative, and every single member of the band is doing something. You know, they're not... like is the case in some of my least favorite Western bands. And a lot of the reason I don't listen to a lot of Western music is because often the musicians feel like they're just following each other around. Whereas you listen to a band like Polkadot Stingray, and it's the quintessential example of a band who can be playing a song like this, which is quite simple on its, you know, you look at the chord patterns and everything, it's quite simple, but they're adding fun to it. You know, there's a lot of funk in the rhythms. There's the bass lines walking around, a little bit of slap, a little bit of walk. You know, there's some great stuff happening in there. The beat as well, it's got those nice sort of touches to it. It's very delicate. There's just, yeah, simple rhythm, but nice little touches and intricacies added in there. And then you look at the lead vocal. She's having a bunch of fun bouncing around on that. She's not pushing her voice hugely. You don't really feel like she's, you know, maxing out her talent or anything. She's just kind of having fun, but she's conveying it with a real great energy, a rhythm. The chorus is very catchy, easy to sing along to. Yeah, in those senses, you could say that, yeah, this is obviously about as commercial as you'd expect Polkadot Stingray to go. That's a commercial. But you know what I mean? It's definitely on the more commercial side of what we lost, at least what I expect from Polkadot Stingray. But there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with that. You can have songs like that. And this was just an absolute joy. I also wanted to point out as well, they do like their colorful videos, but this was, again, this was just jumped off the screen. I know there are some references when I mentioned in the Discord on my main channel that I was going to look at this song, because like someone asked me to give opinions, and I said I can't give opinions yet because I'm going to do a reaction to it. And then I heard someone mentioning that it did have references to previous videos, and that's why when I saw that first frame with the washing machines in the background, I was like, eh. So I don't know how much of this might be references to other videos that I haven't seen, but there was so much on screen, so much fun going on there. And you know, I like those music videos where there's a lot going on the screen, where it's it really feels like you can feel their enthusiasm just bursting out of every frame. And obviously the director really got this song. I don't know who directed it. I'm assuming the director was very much in cahoots with the band about what they wanted to look like. I mean, the band might have directed it for all I know. But yeah, it felt like everything came together with so much joy and enthusiasm and bursts off the screen and bursts through the headphones as well. And a lot of the time we think about joyous music, it's so easy to think about it as being all simple and throwaway and disposable. But this is why bands like Polkadot Stingray are so important, but moreover, why Japanese music is so good at doing this type of music more than I think any other scene on earth, is that, and Polkadot Stingray being a great example of that, is the fact that you can take something which is a simple chord pattern, it's just a sing-along sort of song, not a huge amount of complexity going on in there, and then you can make it absolutely full of fun ideas, of cute little intricacies that make re-listens, I'm sure, very rewarding. You can make a video that is like bursting with creativity. This is why Japanese music is so great. And yeah, Polkadot Stingray, what a brilliant little song. So there you go, JO DEKI. I would definitely enjoy just popping this on. This must have a lot of views. I feel like this is the sort of song that would definitely get millions of views. 280,000. Yeah, I'm not overly surprised. Yeah, it's definitely the sort of song that I just can't help but feel this would be like massively popular. What a great little song. Anyway, yeah, and I hope like over the summer, because it's boiling hot here, but this is the sort of song that I'll just hear in the background. I'll be walking through places and then this will come on. I'll be like, ah, and I'll feel better. Anyway, get in the comments, tell me what you think, and I'm glad, because if you're watching this, it means it wasn't blocked. Tell me what you think, and until I hopefully see you very soon in Japan for the next one of these. For now, ciao, ciao.